Welcome to Anatomy and Physiology at Glen Oaks Community College. I'm Dr. Ren Hartung. We're going to do something a little bit different for this one. We're going to look at the endocrine system. We're going to go through all of the endocrine glands, and then I'll quiz you on those glands. So we're just looking at anatomy on some of the models. This is a brain model, and the endocrine glands that we see up in the brain, back here we have the pineal gland, and then over here under the thalamus we have the hypothalamus. And then down here, we have the pituitary gland. So those are the endocrine glands that we see in the brain. Let's look at a few different torso models that have these structures. This one doesn't really have a brain that has the endocrine glands. But in the neck here, we have an unpainted thyroid gland. The thyroid gland is in the neck. The parathyroid glands, by the way, are behind the thyroid. They're four little nodules on the back of the thyroid on either side. Moving down, the thymus would be in this location, but this model did not have a thymus. The adrenal glands, this is the right adrenal gland. This is the left adrenal gland. And for this model, for pancreas, if I lift up this piece, it fits inside of here, like so. And that yellow bit in the middle is the pancreas. So if I set it down here, we actually have three structures here. We have the pancreas in the middle. And then over here we have the spleen, and at the other end we have the small intestine. This model didn't have any reproductive organs, so let's move on to the next torso model. This is also a relatively inexpensive torso model. It does have a brain that can be removed, but it doesn't really have a pituitary gland. You can kind of see where the pineal gland would be and where the hypothalamus is, but it doesn't really have a pituitary, so let's go to the neck. Here's a nicely painted thyroid gland in the neck, showing you that butterfly shape of the thyroid gland. And remember that the parathyroids are behind the thyroid gland. They're on the back of the thyroid gland. Again, in this basic area here would be the thymus, but this model also doesn't have a thymus. This is the right adrenal gland. This is the left adrenal gland, both above the kidneys. And for this one, the pancreas is on the gut package. If I take the intestine package and set it up in here, this thing up here on top of it, which if you can see the surface, it has kind of a glandular appearance, that's supposed to be the pancreas. So that's pancreas. And reproductive organ-wise, the gonads, this model has female reproductive organs that set in here like this, and if I take it and put it sideways, you can kind of make out where the uterus is, where the bladder is, where the vagina is. These are female reproductive organs, and the thing I'm tapping on with my finger would be the right ovary. So that's the first time we've seen a gonad so far. Moving on to a much larger and more complicated torso model. This torso model had half of a brain up here that I pulled out and put on the bench. This would be the pineal gland back here. And then we have thalamus, therefore this is hypothalamus in this region. The pituitary would be hanging off here, but what they did for this torso model is they left it inside of the skull, lying inside of that feature of the sphenoid bone you might remember called the sella turcica. So that's where the pituitary gland is in this model. Let's go down to the neck. There is thyroid gland. For this model, I actually left in the heart because the thymus lies on top of the heart in this area here, but again, my models don't have thymus on them. Let's go down to the abdomen where we have the right adrenal gland and the left adrenal gland. And then below those, we have the pancreas. Notice that this pancreas has been dissected open to show the pancreatic duct. That's because the pancreas has not only endocrine function, making insulin and glucagon, those hormones, but also it produces pancreatic juice, which is important for the digestive system. So again, that's pancreas. And if we go down into the pelvis of this model, right now it's got female organs in it. This is the uterus. This would be the left ovary, and this would be the right ovary over here. So those are the female gonads. Moving on to my other torso model, I've got a nice, older, good detailed torso model here. Here's the half of the brain. So back in this neighborhood here would be the pineal gland. Up here, or more forward or anterior, is the hypothalamus below the thalamus. And then down here is the pituitary gland. I haven't mentioned infundibulum before, but this little bit here that attaches the pituitary to the brain, or attaches the pituitary to the hypothalamus, that's called the infundibulum. Let's go to the neck in this torso model. There's the, There's the thyroid gland. And then down on the chest would be the thymus. Down lower, I'm going to remove the stomach for right now so we can easily see the right adrenal gland above the kidney and the left adrenal gland above the left kidney. And I'm going to pull the stomach back up here and put it in its proper position roughly. That's where the stomach lies. And behind the stomach, right there, that little bit of yellow that you see, that is the pancreas. And if I turn that stomach around, you can see it really nicely. That's the pancreas. And again, this one has also been opened up to show the pancreatic ducts. This model also is one of those that wasn't given a sex, so we don't have any gonads for this model. Let me really quickly show you the male gonads. I'm going to come over here. This is a pelvic model that's useful. You can nicely see, in this case, the right testicle. And on the other part of the model, we have the left testicle. So those would be the male gonads. I have another model that comes out of that one of the larger torso models that we were looking at over there. This, of course, is the male reproductive structures, and there would be the right testicle. And the left testicle is not visible. It's behind these tissues inside of the scrotum over here. So those are the male gonads. And I think that's pretty much all of the endocrine system. That's about all of the endocrine system I wanted to show you. I'll go on to moving to quiz mode now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to point to different endocrine glands, and then you try and remember and name what they are. I recommend that you write it down while you're doing it. Pause the video if you need to, because directly after asking about them, I'm going to give you the answer. Let's start with this torso model here, and let's go down here. What gland is this? And the answer is, this is the left adrenal gland. It's above the kidney. You can see a piece of the kidney there. This is above that kidney, so this is the left adrenal gland. How about we go down to this model's brain, and we'll say, what is this endocrine gland back here? The answer to that is that this is the pineal gland. And then let's stay with the same model and go up inside the skull, but stay with an endocrine gland that is in the brain, or hanging off the brain, actually. What is this gland? And again, that gland is sitting in the cella turcica. It's the pituitary gland. Let's go down here. How about this gland here, this kind of longish one that comes right up against the spleen? The answer to that is pancreas. This is the pancreas. And then let's go down here into the pelvic cavity. What is this gland? What is this gland? And the answer to that is this is the left ovary. And of course, on the other side, we have the right ovary. Let's jump a little bit. Let's go to this other model here, the smallest one that I have. What is this gland here? The answer to that is the thyroid. This is the thyroid gland. How about this gland down here? That would be the right adrenal gland. And, of course, the left adrenal gland is over here. How about for this little model, what is this yellow gland here? That, again, is the pancreas. For this model, let's put the intestines up here. I know it's a bit difficult to see because it's not painted differently, but if I can get it to sit there, what is this gland here? That is the pancreas. Notice that the pancreas runs between the small intestine and goes up towards the spleen. That's one way to help you notice what it is, even if it looks different from a model you're used to. Since we're still here, let's ask what this one is. What gland is this? And it's the right adrenal gland. And then let's go up here. What gland would be right here in the chest? The answer to that is the thymus. And as long as we're here, let's go a little bit north. What is this gland? And again, this is a thyroid gland. Let's jump to this other big torso model up here. We'll actually go down to its brain. What is this gland here? The answer to that is, again, the pituitary gland. And you can actually see the cella turcica that it rests in, that feature of the sphenoid bone. How about this gland back here? The answer to that is the pineal gland. And then how about over here? This gland is the hypothalamus. And by the way, this piece here between the pituitary gland and the hypothalamus, what do we call that? That's called the infundibulum. And let's go ahead and jump into this torso model's larger bits. What gland is this? And the answer is the thyroid gland. And while we're talking about the thyroid gland, what lies on the back of the thyroid gland? And the answer is the parathyroid glands. What's here in the chest again, but not visible? What gland? Again, that's the thymus. Let's look down here in the abdomen. What gland would this be? And the answer is the right adrenal gland. Therefore, this must be what? The answer is the left adrenal gland. Let's look down here behind the stomach. What gland would this be? And the answer to that is pancreas. That is the pancreas. Let's move on to gonads. What would this endocrine gland be? This one, this is the right testicle. And the left one is covered up by tissues. The right one is visible for this model. Then let's look at the female. What would this endocrine gland be? The answer to that is the left ovary. Therefore, on the other side, we have the right ovary. Here's another male model. Therefore, what is this endocrine gland? And the answer to that is the left testicle. And if I pull this piece off, there's the right testicle. And I think we've pretty much quizzed you on everything. As always, if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments down below. And thank you once again for watching.